Hello, everybody.
Hello.
So I was wondering about the press conference. What was the phobia you mentioned? You obviously...
No, you're in here.
It was something funny, anyway. So.
I'm scared of big things, like planes. Big. Oh. Like, when they're in front of me, it scares me.
She's scared of King Kong.
Yeah.
Godzilla. Can't go see that.
So we think about the older girl groups. What do you think about, like, Supremes? Do you see any connection? The way they were popular and the way you are now.
I don't know. I think, you know, with any band, male or female, every band is a band in their own right. Do you know what I mean? But I think with, you know, the girl bands of today and how since Spice Girls have broken through and there's a lot more, we're really, really proud and we think there's some really, really good music happening. It's very exciting for women.
This whole girl group.
I don't think we caused it. I think, you know, there's always been girl bands around, but with the acceptance of Spice Girls has come along the acceptance of other girl bands.
Well, what do you think about these bands that came after you, like All Saints and Soy Harmony? Have you heard about them? Do you like them?
Girl bands are great.
That's what we've been saying right from the start. Girl power, more girl bands. I mean, that's what we've been waiting for, and we think they're brilliant. They're their own band in their own right. I mean, they're not. We don't feel like they're following us or anything like that.
About this huge publicity, there is almost every day something about you in the press. So do you feel that you have any control on what's going on, or do you have any idea what's going on?
I think with press, you can't really control it anyway, because at the end of the day, they do write what they want to write. And sometimes it's lies, sometimes there might be a bit of truth in there, so you can't worry yourself about it. You just got to be strong in yourself. Really.
Well, what do you think is the most ridiculous rumor or article about you ever?
So many.
Just mention one or two, it's a totally ridiculous.
Makeup because I don't.
There was, you know, recently there was a rumor in England that we were going to split up, and that was rubbish.
And Spice World to movie gives a little bit negative impression about media. All the guys are fat and stupid and so on.
It's a bit of fun aimed at the British tabloids, really, which the whole world over knows.
Is the impression that the film gives, is that the idea you think about media as well?
Yes, some of the media that are a bit cruel, I think. And that's why they've got laws out now on the media, because some of them do go too far, but then again, you know, some of them don't, so.
After all this has happened, do you still feel that you know yourselves? Like,
definitely. We've never lost touch of who we are as individuals, and we keep each other very grounded. You know, we've got some very close friends that do the same, and family. We haven't forgotten where we've come from and who we really are.
You often see some friends you had before all
this. Yeah, they come over.
All the time.
If they're real friends.
Step was it for you to start performing live? How important?
I think we've been really waiting for it for a long, long time. I mean, because there's four trained dancers here. Yeah. We've been to college for singing. Do you know what I mean? So I think we've really, between the five, has really been waiting for it. But and that is the best bit to give back to our fans.
But I think the thing is, it's not been such a big. You know, everyone says, "Oh, you're singing live now." We've been singing live for
a long time.
Well, our first ever
performing live.
Yeah, our first ever TV was live. Do you know what I mean? I don't think people have seen that. But
MTV, that was.
Yeah.
Well, the first real like huge gig was in Istanbul. Is it? That's true. So why was it there? Why not in the UK? That could have been like the most natural.
We thought that basically that Istanbul was, you know, a place that was very undiscovered by the West, you know, and we always liked to go to very provocative places to show people that there was, you know, brought a lot of attention to that, and we always like to sort of unite the world in some way through music, and that is where East meets West, so it's a perfect place.
It's almost saying where East meets West.
We did the trip out here. Really good.
I have a friend from Finland.
Yeah.
Anu. Arnold, yeah, I haven't seen her for years. But
would you like to see her on this trip, or are you planning
to?
Yeah,
I mean, we don't have a lot of time, but she's always really, really sweet girl. I went to college with her, very nice. I like her.
I think she's coming to the concert, I assume.
Oh, really? Oh, it'd be good for her. Yes, then.
Back to the publicity and rumors and articles. There was a huge article in Finland that you know a Finnish man called Henri Saari. Is that true that you've met him?
Who?
Henry the Great, Henri Saari.
No, we've never
met him.
Who is he?
He's actually a porno star. And
good thing.
And there was an article today as well that he was yesterday in your room in the hotel. And that sort of thing.
Maybe on the telly,
So you haven't met him. One of the funniest is also that Baby Spice is actually 32 years old. That's another one.
Boy, she is 32. She's looking good.
Yeah,
that's why she's 22.
If she's 32, how old are the rest of you? She's the Baby Spice, anyway.
I'm 22.
You got a six pack.
Have you got a six pack?
Have I got a six pack? Well,
go
let me
on,
see.
Get them out.
One, two, three.
Get it out there.
Get it out.
I can't be pulling out my stomach on live television.
Bottle
yes, you can.
Go on.
Maybe later.
Go on.
Go on.
So, actually, I was wondering that you've been very mature during this interview. I was sure that you're going to walk all over me through this interview. Have you got more friendly nowadays, or?
We've always been very friendly. We're just very upfront and full of fun, so we leap around a lot.
I think we're saving our energy for when we get up on stage tonight.
Yes.
Do you remember the interview you did in the Much Music?
Much Music in Canada?
Yeah, in Canada, in Toronto.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's my colleague, Master T, you really liked.
Oh,
crossed him.
Really? The guy from, he's from Leeds, but now
he works in...
Yeah,
I know, Master T.
Anyway. Oh, don't you worry about
it. Because we made him show his pants on Canadian television.
It is a relief.
Thank you.
And you're watching Yannicky!
Great to stage.
Thank you.